Do rare pieces offer more than exotics in your game? Yes? Then your loot is broken. Can you get the same loot regardless of difficulty in your game? Yes? Then the design is broken. Are exotics locked behind single player modes in your multiplayer game? Yes? Then your heads are broken. All this and more in a game that, depending on your platform, barely has 1,000 people playing it at any given time. And the players who are left are right to be disillusioned by a lack of content and, more importantly, the developer's demonstration of a lack of direction. Crystal Dynamics, in my opinion, are still trying to make the wrong genre of game. 2 villains, 1 enemy type, and 0 Marvel locations. This game had a choice to make: variety via engaging, replayable endgame modes, or more single-player styled missions. I'm all for world-building, story, and recognize that this is Crystal Dynamics' strength, but just because you're familiar with Archer gameplay does not make it anyone's first choice for a Marvel character in a superhero live service. And you've made it not only the first, but the second as well? The Tachyon Rift missions, Marvel's first DLC, are recycled content with a timer, same mode, with a glorified modifier. A scary taste of what could potentially be the future of this game with an upcoming Archer double feature. I believe mode variety must take priority. In a perfect world, we could focus on both. We could have single player and multiplayer focused things. But the reality is, your dev time would take way too long without prioritizing one over the other. Why? Because the team working on this must be significantly smaller than the one you spent years developing with. And smaller still, considering the less than stellar reception at launch. A looter with broken loot, a live service lacking social features. Instead of releasing actual new content, we are looking for bug fixes, quality of life updates, performance stabilization, and all kinds of things that separate this title from where it should have been at launch. But it certainly won't get there anytime soon unless the focus is shifted to changing this. 2 villains, 1 enemy type, and 0 Marvel locations is unacceptable. Double this amount is still unacceptable. Not for a Marvel live service where you need to entice players onto the hamster wheel. If you need to dump new villains and new enemy types and confine them to that mission exclusively, do it. A patrol mode, flight missions, payload, wave-based horde modes, do it. Make an invasion mission where unkillable villains hunt the players down, with high priority enemies dropping badass loot that the player can only keep if they make it to extraction. Do it. Hire someone to verse themselves in other life services and see what the industry offers players within your genre, because you seem blind. This is a fight for players' attention, for their time, all of which is limited. Fortnite, Genshin Impact, Call of Duty, Warframe, Monster Hunter, the list goes on. These games are ruthless in the ever-changing experiences that they endeavor to offer their players. You're making me sound like an investor, but honestly, I kinda wish that I could go full Karen. Y'all don't have bosses? Y'all don't have people breathing down your neck trying to make sure that you do what's right for the future of this game? Or are you just running out the clock on the contract that you have and the license? You know what I mean? Myself and many former Marvel Heroes players are flabbergasted at the ball that you've dropped so hard that it's left a Mjolnir-sized crater. But even mentioning my man makes me sad. Thor, but no Asgard. No locations. It's more like Kamala meets the Avengers, the game. People can call me a hater all they want, boy. Many of us have such a soft spot for Marvel, for these comics that we read decades ago. We never could have imagined the cultural impact they'd have today. What a lucrative property it's become. Can you please do better? Can you please focus? Villains, modes, Marvel locations, comic book skins, and at the very least, Can we have custom harm room modifications and environments while we wait? It's one room. It's a holographic room. Can we play as the same character in the harm room? I think it's funny that in the single player mode, Kamala can turn into Iron Man, but we can't all turn into Iron Man? It's weird. It's strange, right? It's bizarre. Just... I think we're...